Rick Hong here for Hollywood First Look Features. Today, I am with Stephen Dorff, and we are talking his movie, Embattled. Stephen, I wanted to tell you congratulations. I'm always a fan and like enjoy your work. So this movie takes place in the backdrop of MMA. So is that why you sign up? Are you a fan of MMA? Or was it more the story between the father and son?
I mean, the first thing, you know, always to me, like the script, and the script was just incredible. I mean, David McKenna is a writer that I had known a little bit as a person, but I knew his work. I mean, I love Blow. I loved American History X.
Yeah.
I knew what it was about beforehand, but going in, you know, really, I was blown away by the whole piece. I was blown away that there was this incredible kind of dysfunction, father and son family movie there in a very realistic way, set against the backdrop, like you said, of MMA and UFC type stuff. So it to me felt like a no-brainer, you know. And then I met the director, Nick, this was his kind of first American film, and he was a very quiet Russian guy, but seemed to very, you know what he was doing, seemed to kind of take his time with this script. And you know, when I finished True Detective, you know, I kind of signed up beforehand, but I went right into the training and we went right into this.
How was it working with Stephen Dorff? Because I'm watching the movie and his character, there's just really nothing likable about his character, which says something about your directing and also, you know, Stephen's performance. But I don't know if it also helps working with him, knowing that when he was younger, he also did, you know, The Power of One with, you know, John Avildsen, who like did Rocky.
Yeah, he also did Faison, which is a very like fight-oriented movie. And working with Steven is an absolute joy. Like, it's sometimes nerve-wracking, but it's absolutely a great experience. And he's so into it, like month ahead of production, he would like call me and come up with the ideas for the character and like some parts of his look. And then like when you've talked for months with this guy in prep, right? And then he shows up on the scene and then boom, it's a different person. And like, sometimes it's a scary person. So that was surreal.
Well, okay. So let's talk about the character. Since you said that you guys were talking and prepping everything, whose idea is it for the gold tooth? His or yours, or is it in the script?
So it was his idea and he didn't even like tell me. One day he like sends me a
cell.
He's like, what do you think? And I'm like, this is perfect.
How was the training? Because I've always known you to be a really fit guy anyways. I even want to say when I watched your season of True Detective, I felt like maybe they put a little bit of a paunch on you. Maybe I might be confusing that. But how? Like, but like, I don't know if like you had to really say like, I've got like 5 weeks, 6 weeks before I get to set for Embattled. So like, I need to start drinking protein shakes or I need to start doing more push-ups.
It's confusing. I hate protein shakes, number one. I just hate it, you know.
Me too.
A trainer would probably be happy for me, but I'd rather just, you know, eat food. And so like True Detective, yeah, definitely when Roland ages, I'm wearing a big old belly in that and it changes my whole posture. But you know, because I signed on, I was starting to work out quietly like on my weekends and when I had a day off. But I knew, and I had it all set to when I was going to wrap True Detective and we ran late, I would get to LA and I would have at least 4 weeks in LA to train with my guy from Montreal where I could just start eating and putting some size on. Because I felt like I was a little scrawny for this guy. And because I've done a lot of fighting, not MMA fighting, but fighting in movies and the basics, you know, they didn't really have to teach a newcomer how to do that. It was, you know, I pick up things pretty fast. I needed to learn certain moves. I knew the kind of fighter Cash was going to be. You know, he's a scrapper. He'd do anything to win. He'll cheat if he has to. He's a champion.
Yeah.
It's an incredible movie. I feel like the exploration of a special needs child and the relationship with an older sibling, a mother having a special needs child, you know, the scenes that I'm not in that are in there are heartbreaking, I think. I think the film just has so much. And yet, for the fight fans, delivers some really intense fight scenes, I think, that we haven't seen before in a long time. Look, I'm an actor, so I'm supposed to be able to do everything. So that's my job, and I play in the venue that I'm playing in with the complete truth to that venue. So I feel like we did that in the MMA world for this, and the community's starting to respond, and that makes me happy, you know?
You absolutely did. And that's why I love watching in all your work. Congratulations on a great career so far. I mean, it's been so long. Please stay safe and healthy during this time.
Thank you. You too, my friend.
Thank you. The movie is Embattled. You can catch it on video on demand. Until next time, I'm Rick Hall.
Tomorrow night, you die. Dance with the devil, huh? Don't bet on it.
Video, don't forget to click the subscribe button and get notified of our latest entertainment interviews.